the brain. Shut up, it's been the most stressful week of my life. And it's been the most controversial week in the history of Big Brother, and there's still a week to go. Anything can still happen, but I'm praying to God nothing happens. So on tonight's show, we're going to look at the winners and losers. But first, the aftermath. With Jade leaving the house on Friday, it marked the end of one of the most tumultuous periods in the history of Big Brother and Big Brother's lifetime. So who has been affected the most? Have Joe and Danielle mended their ways?
No.
Well, let's not do that item then. Has Jack actually spoken a word? Is the house a wonderful, harmonious place now Jade's gone?
No.
All right, look a bit more, feel a bit more up about it. Here to explain the intriguing concept of group transmutation is the thinking man's thinking woman, Julie James.
Hello, lovely Julie. Oh, it's nice to see a smiling face. Oh, OK, Julie, transmutation. What
is it and what's it got to do with Jade's departure?
It's a natural form of group regeneration. So a group loses its alpha leader, and in Jade's case, it was a group within a group, and it was almost as though she'd died.
Really?
Well, you know when they get ejected from the group? They kind of, they mourn them, don't they?
So that's how it feels.
They've got two choices then as a group. They either disperse, and that means that they submit and they just have to join the rest of the housemates.
So they disband.
Or they re-recruit and add to their numbers and kind of come back fighting. That means that they're going to need an out-group victim as well and a new leader.
So it means they need someone to pick on and someone that's in charge.
Did you ever see the film Jeepers Creepers?
Yes, terrifying.
You know the monster, when its head got knocked off, it just took another head and put it on and started again? That's like group regeneration.
Only you could do this.
I did it well, though, didn't I?
A horror movie, and I like that because it appeals to me. Before we go through what's happened to Jade's gang since she left, here's a reminder of Joe, Danielle and Jack, what they were like when Jade was in the house. Some of this doesn't make particularly pretty viewing.
Bitch.
The chicken will be done by 3 o'clock.
The what?
The chicken?
Of course it will be.
No wonder I keep getting shits.
She's fucking doing my head in.
Not only are you fake, you're a liar. There you go. Boom, boom.
You can look at people like I'm a
Joe, I mean, are you going to say something here? I mean, what is happening here?
I'm not finding this funny.
Really?
Set of Golden Girls.
Okay, just a simple case of Jade leading and the gang following?
No, I think that is too simple. I mean, the big telling point would be whether the behaviour ceased when Jade left, but in fact it didn't.
And well, I think that's what everyone expected to happen. Everyone expected the leader's gone, but
that's not happened. You know, Jade had certain controlling qualities. I mean, she had a lot of knowledge when she went in. That made her quite powerful. Also, she had a lot of physicality. She kind of shouts the loudest, really. And that gave her the look of a leader to that group. But I think all of that group have got their own control qualities. Danielle, since the moment she went in, has been very controlling in that house, albeit in a kind of baby behaviour way. And I think the thing with babies is, and small children, they can be quite manipulative. They're very good at getting their own way. And so despite the fact that she's got the very childlike persona, I think she's been quite in charge of certain aspects of what's going on. She's very flexible as a personality as well. Joe was that little bit older and I think was a big pop star. So I think Jade might have actually been in awe of her and trying to impress her.
Right.
And Jack, you know, he doesn't speak much, but he does this kind of whispering his little wisdoms into Jade's ear. And also, he controls her emotionally as well. So, you know, it wasn't all down to Jade being in control.
OK, then let's take a look at the gang post-Jade.
Give us a smacker.
I'll give you a smacker, all right.
Oh!
Ooh. Get your fat ass off the couch.
Oh, he loves to taunt me, don't you, my love?
Tart.
Keep it coming.
I think we should put things in his pockets when he's not looking.
Yeah.
I think it'll crack anyway, whether we do something or not. Might just take a day or two longer.
Crack.
crack.
Dirk's problem is he doesn't have any manners.
He doesn't. He doesn't need them, though. He lives by himself with Dirk.
In Montana.
He can't use that as an excuse. I live on my own, and it's not like he's lived on his own his whole entire life.
I think he's bitter with women.
Sorry.
Sometimes he's happy, sometimes he's sad. When he's had a drink, he fucking goes off as fucking nut.
Okay, so what's happened since Jay's left?
Well, this was interesting because, you know, there was a kind of moment of fear. I think there was a moment straight after Jade left when certainly Danielle and Joe, they said they were scared. Danielle, if you remember, was doing all that kind of self-comfort hair twiddling.
Right.
But then what they needed was a new leader. And I thought it was fascinating because you got this fence sitter, Cleo, who suddenly got into Jade's seat while it was still warm. And, you know, like the Jeepers Creepers, you know, she became the head of Cleo on almost the body of Jade, you know. She suddenly.
So what's happened? Why has that happened?
It was absolutely remarkable, and you do need to track it back. I'm not quite sure. It's as though I think maybe we watched her fence sitting and thought that she was thinking one thing, but I think she was actually waiting to join in and maybe take over. She moved in really quickly. Then all they needed was this out-group victim that they could deal with, and in a way, Dirk filled that gap for them as well, albeit different treatments with him. But he gave them focus, and that creates very strong bonds in the group. Mm. If they've got somebody in the out-group, it makes the in-group stronger. So it's a kind of
survival
process.
So you need almost like
process.
A figure of hate that's somewhere... Not hate, maybe, but sort of somewhere else.
Just somebody, as I say, out-group. That's the whole thing. That makes this group stronger.
Why Dirk, do you think?
I don't know what happened with Dirk. I mean, it just seemed that I think he was possibly the only potential victim left in a lot of ways. Maybe it was the cigar smoking, I don't know. I mean, Cleo said it was something to do with him discussing porn. I don't think it was that. I think he was the only one available, to be honest.
OK. What about the other gang in the house? The gang, I guess. You wouldn't exactly
Jermaine.
Call it a gang, but...
It's not really a gang, but, I mean, you know, you've got Jermaine. I think he's still got this slightly father figure influence in there. He seems to be coasting along now, I think.
No one would take him on now, would they?
He's still slightly at risk. I think the big problem is that he will act as a little bit of an authoritarian figure. And I think that's possibly what happened with Dirk as well. And when you do that type of behaviour, you often get the rebellious child behaviour will start coming back on you.
Yeah.
But at the moment, he's fine. I mean, he just seems quite popular.
OK.
Ian is so much on the fence, isn't he? I mean, Ian is not coming off that fence. Ian is going to be on that fence, I think, by the time the next Big Brother starts.
Yeah.
So he is actually mediating slightly, but he's not really going to mix it with anybody.
Okay, and what about Shilpa?
Shilpa cried when Jade left, and I think in a way she was feeling a degree of fear as well, but not like the other girls. I think she was rather worried. I mean, she could be accused of having seen off three of the strong females in the house with Jackie, Carol and Jade.
Is that what she was worried about?
I think so, and that could have made her unpopular. Certainly it could have created an atmosphere in the house, but also unpopular with the public, with the voters. But I think once she realised that, no, you know, she wasn't voted out because she was popular, she's almost become a different girl. She's very relaxed, she's joining in the fun, she's able to mix with everybody, and I think she's using her skills of intellect, even sexual skills as well, to create very strong bonds in there. Maybe even flexing her leadership muscles. And I think people like Big Brother characters to get in there with the action. I think
she's done that.
So I think she deserves a nice positive response for the rest of the journey. In
there. Yeah, I don't think there's going to be any danger with that. Thanks a lot, Julie, everyone. Test time. As you know, we make all our housemates undergo various personality tests. Here's one they didn't do. This is a board, as you can see. It indicates, well, how you sleep indicates certain personality traits. Judy?
I'd love to be log, but I'm fetus, I'm afraid.
Me too. Find out which one applies to you and the housemates after the break. Scene four. Welcome back to Big Brother's Big Brain, the psychology show that can spot a fake a mile away. Before the break, I told you the position you sleep in indicates certain personality traits you might have. Here are the options. Lovely Sharon.
Hi.
Hello, who's holding it for us? Thank you very much, Sharon. The fetus position is the most popular sleeping position, my personal favourite. those of you who curl up in the fetus position are described as tough on the outside with a sensitive heart, very much like myself. Which housemates do you think sleep in the fetus position, young ladies?
Oh, I think H.
You think H? Yeah.
I think that it's got to be Jade's other half.
Jade's other half. Jade. I love the fact no one calls him Ian. He went in the house and just went, I want to be called Ian. I was thinking, hey, I always do it as well. Anyone?
Cleo, probably.
I think Cleo. Yeah. The answer is do Joe and Danielle. There we go. Artist interpretation. Oh, indeed. The soldier position. Where's the soldier position? Thanks a lot, Sharon. You absolutely nailed that, Sharon. Nice touch. Is the fourth most popular in the world. People in this position apparently generally quiet and reserved. They don't like fuss, but set themselves and others high standards. Any thoughts?
I wasn't listening, sorry.
You weren't listening to what I was just saying? Turn that chair around. Get up, turn that chair around. Found the corner that way. Sit down. Hello, my love.
Sorry, I'm going to have to turn that
You're
way
You're going to
as
turn
well.
Around as well. No one's listening to what I'm saying. Story of my love life. The answer is... Like, you're just still randomly shouting out names now, like you're pretending. You can turn around now, it's fine. And this position is the log position. The second most popular position. People who sleep in this position are easygoing and social. They like to be part of the in crowd. And perhaps trusting and maybe a little bit gullible, which sounds like me. Hello. Which housemates do you think might sleep in that position?
Joe.
Oh, good answer. Yeah. Let's see if you're right. Whack, whack, oops to you.
I'm so right.
It's Ian. Now, of course, not all our housemates fit into these categories. For example, Jermaine has his own. It's the I'm too lazy to put on my pyjamas and actually get into my bed position. Look at him. He looks like a hobo. Now, the Celebrity Brother is an intense experience. We all know that for the housemates. Some play it well, some play it not so well. Apparently, a housemate's success is related to what psychologists call social intelligence. And who better to explain all than the best damn-looking lecturer in the world of psychology? Admittedly, not that much of an accolade. It's Dr. Thomas Chamado, pre-music. Hey, Dr. Thomas, how are you?
All right.
Okay. So, what is social intelligence?
It's the ability to get along with others, to act wisely in social relationships, and just to succeed in social interpersonal relationships. So, IQ can help you do well in mathematics or, verbal abilities, yep. Reading, learning. Social intelligence is defined according to being successful with others.
So, essentially, if you walk into a room, there's a group of people in there you don't know, like the Big Brother house, it's how well you integrate with all those people and not play them off against each other, but how well you fit into that group, right?
Here is a lot more complicated than that, because it's not just reading other people, but also interpreting the audience at home and knowing what they want to do. And okay. As we can see in the charts we're going to show now, social intelligence is related and a very good predictor of how well people are doing.
And how well they do when they come out as well?
Correct. How well they're doing doesn't mean if they're going to win the show or not, but also what kind of public image they will have when they leave the house.
Okay. Using social intelligence as a guide, you've ranked the housemates as to winners and losers. We're going to have a look at the housemates you think have got the most in the Big Brother experience so far. Let's have a look.
Jermaine's adorable, and he's so calm. I thought I was calm till I met him.
Nothing ever phases Jermaine, does it?
He is very, very nice man, and I've got a lot of respect for him.
You can't reason with people who are beyond reason.
You can't control what she says, you can only control what comes out of your mouth.
Jermaine is really the rock of Gibraltar right now.
When I'm gone, I'm gonna miss everybody, really, because my love is real. It's I'm one way.
Thanks, Jermaine.
Thanks, Jermaine.
Thank you.
Thank
you.
I'm older than you, this is wisdom.
Now the game begins.
I don't want to be too nice.
This is my fourth day without a shower. Has anybody noticed?
Yeah.
No, seriously.
Dirty Dirk.
I've been teasing a lot. And I told him I hadn't showered in 4 days, but it's not true.
All those cigars and guns, that just was a cover for something. The gay team.
Okay, Thomas, who is at the top of the table?
Definitely Jermaine. I mean, the man is a legend. If they did a new version of The Godfather, he would have to play Marlon Brando. He's so wise, clever, smart, balanced. His main trait is moderation. He's mastered the art of moderation.
Well, he's just been so serene all the way through as well, and just, I think, probably due to the fact his family, and but just the way he carries himself. People always seem to look up to him, don't they?
The man is very charismatic, very wise socially. I mean, at the beginning, I think people thought he was a little bit detached from reality, but we can see he's very wise. He represents all the wisdom in the house, and there isn't that much of it.
OK. You also think that Dirk could be a big winner. How come? Because Dirk's been a bit grouchy last couple of days.
Well, I think he's a winner already, even if he was evicted now. You know, the public support adulation, I think he scores very high on that. I think he's a little bit grumpy sometimes, he's moody, he has his ups and downs, but his main trademark is consistency. He always behaves in the same manner, regardless of what people think or want, and I think people respect him for that.
Yeah, he's his own man.
He's his own man. It's almost as if he couldn't be bothered to be in the show, and he said it many times, but that is his biggest asset. He's genuine.
Okay. There's winners, there's obviously got to be losers. Let's take a look at the people you don't think have good social intelligence.
I think it's a prerequisite to be a celebrity on a celebrity show, and he's here because of Jade.
Why have I got nipples?
Can he read?
Big Brother will let you know in due course.
What does due course mean? My uncle does that, shoots pheasants. Got a big ass in Norfolk.
Norfolk is north, obviously.
Yeah, I don't know where it is.
About that cat. My bit.
I'm a funny little creature. I'm a
loser, baby. The thing that aggravates me with Shilpa is she fingers your food.
Dirk's problem is he doesn't have any manners. He's just an ass.
He's a miserable old man.
What are your feelings about the argument?
It wasn't my argument. So it's not really affected me at all, really.
OK, you think Joe and Jack are the big losers. Who's at the bottom of the class?
I would put Joe at the bottom. I think she's worse, because at least she was a celebrity when she entered the house, whereas Jack, you know, there wasn't anything there in the first place.
Why is Joe down so low?
I think she's down solo because, you know, she's very bitter and angry, almost like a hidden voucher there, waiting for conflict to happen and then be happy when somebody had experienced some attack or a fight with anybody else. So that she's very bitter and very unable to even succeed in relationships. She depends on other people to be victorious, to progress and move upwards.
Okay, what about Jack?
Well, there isn't much there, is there? I mean, social intelligence, you name it. His highlight in the show was to ask whether he has nipples or not. What else can we say about him? I think he's either insignificant or ridiculous.
But do you think he's missed a trick? Because since Jade's gone out, this is like his opportunity to assimilate himself with the
people. I was hoping for him to do something, but he's not doing anything at all. So I think he had the chance, especially after Jade and Jackie left. He's not doing anything. He should have left after 2 days.
Time to move on to the final category, the housemates, whose success and social intelligence you're kind of undecided about. It could go one of either two ways. Let's take a look.
No! I am, like, working days. I am, like, Ted and stuff as well.
I don't fucking trust her.
No, I don't trust her.
Oh, my goodness, have come out!
Well, I'm sorry, but I want to have fun the last week that we have. We should just have fun. God, these people.
Would you say you've learnt anything from today's experiences?
Yes, probably, but not to just follow the crowd.
Where one can't build a bridge to the other must build a bridge. You know, and so if there's a bridge, people can walk over it.
He's playing hard to get. I heard your tactics. Ignore him, he said. Ignore this love.
It's hard because you want to make people laugh. I want to make people feel good. That's my thing anyway in life. Because he's an old man talking about porn. It's not nice to young girls, not nice at all.
I'm just going to stay neutral and be happy.
To be honest, I try and keep myself
good
out of
it. That's the best way out.
It's really, really hard to stay neutral.
OK, I'm a bit confused, because I thought Cleo would have high social intelligence.
Until Friday, we all thought she would have, but then after that, I think, you know, she hasn't done very well for herself. I think she can read other people, and for the first couple of weeks, she was acting a little bit like Jermaine, being sort of a mother figure, motherly figure, and wise. But then, I don't know if it's desperation or the need to be funny. It hasn't been a very wise move for herself.
OK, what about Danielle? Because I thought you'd maybe group her in with Joe and Jack.
So, but you're undecided about her too?
Many people think that, but I'm still undecided because I think there's been good and bad from Danielle. And I think she's
What's
still...
been good from Danielle?
Well, I think the first week was very good, and she's sort of in a more, you know, she's naive, a little bit childish, but I think if she's influenced by the wrong people, that's the bad Danielle we see. But yeah. Otherwise, if she's sort of in a good mood, and she's a very positive character, and she can be quite likable.
Okay, and Ian?
Ian, as Judy said, sitting in the fence, not doing much, but that actually has been very good for himself. So whilst Cleo and Danielle are going downwards, down the hill, Ian is going upwards, simply because they are going down. But I do think that he's learning to adapt to the situations in the house and read the dynamics and to be grouped with the right people.
Also, yeah, in terms of social intelligence, he does speak to a lot of different people, doesn't he? He sort of gets on well with everyone.
He does, and he's been hanging out more and more with the right camp, really.
OK. Now, he said before he went in the house, people don't really have a big opinion on him. In his profile, he said he wanted to change people's thinking that he was the blonde knob from Steps. Is he still the blonde knob from Steps?
Yes.
OK. And finally, Shilpa. Let's take a look. You think Shilpa's obviously done very well, yeah?
Shilpa, very well. I mean, she's in a league of her own, top. If the show finished today, she would have won it by miles. And not just won it, but won it in style. Mm. She's worked very hard for it, and I can't see her losing.
OK, listen, only got 20 seconds left, but tell me who do you think is going to win?
I don't like to make obvious predictions, but I like to make the right predictions, and I think Jermaine will win it.
Jermaine's going to win. Thanks a lot. That's all for tonight. It's the last Big Brain for a while. Catch me on BBLB during the week. Take care. God bless. Have a good night. Bye-bye.